I like the world from up here. I can pinpoint where I'd settle, on that brown lump by the patch of trees. What country even is this? By the thin lick of river. Yes, by the water, just there. In the middle of nowhere. Look at him bending down now to collect the day. I could spend all my time there, spinning axes and stationary things. A noonday dream. Ben Howard's music is a very interesting evolution to experience. His debut album, Every Kingdom, was a warm-hearted, fun, passionate, romantic album full of beautiful songs and an overall happy tone to it. He attracted an audience mainly of young females at that point, with people thinking he would be another Ed Sheeran-type artist. And then he released his sophomore album, I Forget Where We Were. This project had a darker and more serious tone to it than Every Kingdom, while still retaining certain aspects from that album. It does still have some happy songs in it, but they are definitely of a different flavor than what came before. There's a lot of uncertainty and hurt in I Forget Where We Were, but Ben managed to retain most of his audience while expanding it through his new style. His most recent album, Noonday Dream, shows Ben evolving as a person and is very distant in almost every way from his first two LPs. It shows us a mature man entering a new stage in his life, and nearly every aspect is different, from the writing style to the actual sound of the music. I don't want to simply focus on what was released on the album, since there are a few unreleased tracks written in this point in time, along with an EP featuring recordings done during the recording of Noonday Dream. I want to include everything he is doing at this point of his life to best encapsulate this era of his music. Noonday Dream was released in 2018 by Republic Records, and stands as Ben Howard's third full-length album. It released to mixed reviews, with many people feeling that the album was boring or too weird. The truth is that Ben is a human. He's growing as a person, and his music will always go with him. He's never concerned himself with people's opinions about his music, but is more interested in writing what means something to him. I love all of his music, and I love each album for different reasons. Many people just want him to keep making Every Kingdom over and over again, so an album showing him distancing himself from that even more than I Forget Where We Were left a group of people feeling unhappy. For those who actually take time to sit down and listen to this project and its surrounding tracks, you will quickly see that this is not just another album released by a label from an artist meeting a contractual obligation. My favorite thing about Ben's music is his writing. His use of analogies and figurative language makes his music so much more interesting than a lot of what I hear. The title, Noonday Dream, is a really well done one because of just how well it encapsulates this stage in his music. There's a strong feeling of reflective stillness represented in his music right now, and the title does this idea justice. It reminds me of lying in a hammock or sitting by a pool in a lawn chair in the afternoon, having a moment to just be and think about nothing and everything at the same time. A hazy, calm, content feeling, but one where you can't ignore the things that you've experienced. See, this is what I meant. Nothing that Ben Howard says is as simple as it may seem. Every line can be analyzed and has some sort of a deeper meaning to it, and often if you don't look for what that might be, the writing makes no sense. Every letter means something here. Through Ben's career, we've seen some very happy, very warm moments in his life, but he's also shared the darker and more challenging parts as well. In Noonday Dream, he seems to have settled down into a place where he is now looking back on his life, appreciating the good, but also acknowledging and in some cases, regretting the bad. In the opening track, Nika Libre's At Dusk, Ben is quoted saying, "Door is locked, my gums are bleeding," and a few lines later, "Clothes are off, my health receding." Now, this is simply interpretation, but to me it seems here that Ben is potentially regretting and questioning health decisions he's made. He has been a smoker for quite a while, so this line would make sense, "My gums are bleeding." He is clearly struggling with past decisions at this point in his life, and is trying to come to terms with it by accepting it as just part of his journey. He wouldn't be where he is today if he hadn't done everything exactly the way he had. There are some songs that show that Ben has some amount of anger inside of him still, mainly the defeat. This is one of my favorite songs by him, and there is a lot in this one where he's clearly very angry at the state of the world and aspects of himself. Overall, however, the album is a reflective piece, so as far as conflict is concerned, I suppose it could be considered as a disdain for the state of the world and certain past decisions or events in his life. I order a collider and seem to count my dollars and watch eagles soar in circles. Ben Howard is interesting not only as an artist, but also as a person. He's not interested in having stadiums full of screaming fans, backstage parties mean nothing to him, he is generally annoyed by press and tends to stay out of the public eye and remain as private as possible. He's been quoted saying that when he is performing, he's introverted in front of people, meaning that even when he's on stage playing for a large crowd, he is still staying within his own mind and remains introverted. The fact that he rarely does any sort of interview or press work makes it difficult to really see who he is, but in the few interviews with him you can find, he seems like a very genuine, happy, fun, and loving person.
Now I'm quintessentially a happy person. I try and get rid of all that stuff in music, and it's quite nice to... I take it all really seriously, definitely. Probably too seriously sometimes, but just to get rid of, offload a little bit in songwriting and...
Reporters have claimed that he can be quite irritable and frustrated with them. One unfortunate reporter asked Ben what he thought about his music being lumped into a slew of pop music alongside Ed Sheeran and others by someone writing an online article, to which Ben replied, "I couldn't give a fuck what he thinks." He's clearly no fan of press and prefers to stay out of the public eye as much as possible, which I like. It shows that he really is just about sharing stories and expressing himself through music, which is slowly becoming less and less common with many artists. Out of his lyrics, you can infer that he has a poetic mind, respects and lives through the spectrum of emotion from bliss to despair, and deeply cares about the people around him. He is not without struggle and needs a way to express himself. This is something I relate with very deeply in regards to music, hence why his music speaks so deeply to me and I feel so connected to it. There aren't many other artists who I feel this connected to through their music. You can hear in his voice that he's not writing music for the sake of making music. He's genuinely doing what he can to express his thoughts and feelings and uses what he makes as an outlet.
We've got a pizza box burning on the fire.
It should be burning.
Oh, wow. Wow.
I'm Captain America.
Holy shit, you are on it.
As I've said a few times, I feel that the biggest theme at play currently in Ben's music is reflection. It feels like he's sitting somewhere nice, just looking back on his life and the things he's experienced. One line from Nika Libre's At Dusk represents this very well. 10 Marlboro cigarettes, the butts rolled into a bottle. Today I will stare at the sea until my eyes have had enough. He's just being somewhere, acknowledging the world around him and being only where he is. Another theme at play would be a clear disdain for the current state of the world. One of my favorite songs ever written, Murmurations, the closing song on Noonday Dream, finds Ben saying, "So peaceful here, no one to fuck it up." This to me is him saying that he's finally somewhere peaceful where he can just lay down and be without anyone coming and getting in the way of that. He is tired of the general lifestyle that most people just accept. This entire song represents this. Ben is just being. In another one of my favorite songs ever written, The Defeat, which is the angriest song on Noonday Dream, Ben says, "In a world void of Petrov our savior, we are taught to savor everyone else's failure." Stanislav Petrov is known as the man who single-handedly saved the world from nuclear war. It seems like a lot of our culture is focused on people matching an arbitrary standard, and when people don't live up to that exact standard, they are seen as a lesser person. When another person does live up to that standard, it's a great ego booster to look down on the person who doesn't, because then you feel somehow more accomplished than them and you feel better about yourself. Feeding ego, however, is the most damaging thing a person can do. Overall, the stage of his music is simply about being where you are, finding your own path in life, and living the life that makes you feel happy. The way things are going, the human race is very quickly declining into something that will be very difficult to find our way out of, and Ben is expressing these themes in Noonday Dream. For me personally, each of his albums connects to my life in a different way. Every Kingdom is the happy, social, with close friends, let's take advantage of the moment, let's have fun and love each other aspect of me. I Forget Where We Were speaks to me in a darker and a bit more of a private way. To sum it up, I can relate with a lot of what he speaks about in this album, and it makes me feel less alone in a dark place. Let's just leave it at that, although it goes much deeper. Ben's current stage of music connects with a more vague and hard to describe aspect of myself. A very internal, hazy, more dreamlike level of my everyday life. It's extremely hard to articulate, but I suppose the simplest way to word it would be that it speaks to the at-peace, borderline psychedelic person in me. Again, it's impossible to properly articulate, but if you get it, you get it. I'm obviously very positive about all of Ben's work. Noonday Dream is a rarity in the sense of what it talks about and how deeply it goes into those feelings and experiences. There really is no music like this, and that's one thing I look for in music. I want something different, and I want something that goes all in with being different and disregards when people say it's bad just because it's not like everything else. The thing with Ben's music that disconnects it from most music is that he's not writing standard lyrics. These songs are poetry put to instruments, which makes it all so much more interesting than the majority of what's heard on the radio, for example. Ben has said he would like to, at some point, just retire himself to a cabin and write poetry, which has become even clearer than before with his newer music. His untitled, unreleased song he uses to lead into the Defeat While on Tour, which I like to call Rooks, feels perfectly like a poem mixed with guitar. The same can be said for songs like Bird on a Wing, Murmurations, Sister, A Boat to an Island on the Wall, Agatha's Song, and many more. By the way, Bird on a Wing is one of the deepest and most impactful songs I've ever listened to. The writing in Ben's work is immaculate. And even with some of these songs sounding very strange on first listen, each song is incredibly sonically pleasing. His fantastic guitar technique represented in Every Kingdom in some of his earlier music is less focused at this stage, save for Another Friday Night, the opening song in a 10-minute, 3-song EP titled Another Friday Night / Hot Heavy Summer / Sister. There are many amped and altered guitar sounds present here, with distorted, warped, wavy sounds being used frequently. Acoustic guitar is still present, but is not as highlighted as it used to be. Pace-wise, the LP has a fantastic opening 3 songs, Nika Libre's At Dusk, Towing the Line, and A Boat to an Island on the Wall, and when you open that strongly, it's difficult to keep that going. The awestruck feeling of starting this album off cuts a bit for me with What the Moon Does and Someone in the Doorway, which I don't love as much as the first few. I do still really enjoy those songs, they're just not as deep to me as the first three. Afterwards, we get a very short muffled song called All Down the Mines, leading into The Defeat, which picks back up on the blissful feeling of listening to this album. A Boat to an Island on the Wall Part 2 / Agatha's Song is absolutely fantastic. This song leads into There's Your Man, which is a nice song, but doesn't hit me on the same emotional level as some of the others. We close with Murmurations, which is fantastic. So overall, the pace is very good, with a few slight lulls for me, but even those moments still have some great songs in them, so it's really not a huge deal. This is truly such a well-crafted LP, and the surrounding tracks pretty much all hit the spot in my head. Ben has released a truly beautiful and deeply touching era of music which not many artists have managed to pull off as well as he has here. He is an artist that will be remembered as one of the best, I guarantee that. He's an artist of rare talent, skill, and ability to beautifully express himself through music. His popularity has gone down since his style changed so much, and this style definitely doesn't appeal to everyone, but for those who have stuck around and still listen, this isn't just music. This is a journey through someone's life and relates to so many things we all go through. I'm glad to say I live in a world where Ben Howard lives, and I feel so fortunate to have someone be creating art the way that he does. And